is an exclusive presentation of Turner Sports. In 1998, cable television's exclusive host for the 18th Olympic Winter Games from Nagano, Japan, and the 4th Goodwill Games from New York.
Another season featuring familiar faces in new places. A familiar face back in a familiar place. And a face that may look for a new place. New coaches. New players. All in pursuit of the ultimate dream. A dream that a certain face has been monopolizing. There is a blend of youth and experience. There is wisdom and the potential for magic. Who will win the chase for the title? The race is on to answer these questions, and it starts right now on TNT. In Boston tonight, a new era begins under the guidance of Rick Pitino. Antoine Walker and the Celtics host Michael and the Bulls. And then later, to Los Angeles, a rematch of the Western Conference semis. The Lakers and the Jazz square off at the Forum. It is opening night of the NBA season, and for the ninth year, the NBA on TNT is right here. Our doubleheader begins an hour from now in Boston, then moves to L.A. Good evening, everybody. It is great to be back in your living room. I'm Ernie Johnson, and along with me for our one-hour season preview, NBA tip-off 97, they call her coach, the Hall of Famer who led the Phoenix Mercury to the WNBA playoffs.
Cheryl Miller. Seemed just like yesterday.
Not for me.
Okay.
I have really missed you, and it's great to have you
Ernie,
back.
I call her beautiful. I don't call her coach.
I do, too, but not on TV. And he's number 30 on the all-time NBA scoring list, twice an All-Star. For more, check page 414 of the NBA Register.
Believe that.
Reggie
Let's
Theus.
Let's get this party started, right?
That's what we're all about here. So what, you ask, are we going to give you for the next hour? Well, check this off. A little playoff intensity carried over on Halloween. A game day scuffle between Shaq and Greg Ostertag. It happened at Shoot Around. We'll have the details in just a few minutes. Meantime, Sir Charles. Well, he went to New York. He met with league officials this morning. You could forget that retirement talk. For now, at least, he wants to play. Our preview of the Bulls will focus on early season life without Scottie Pippen. How will the Bulls fare in the early going? And a legend returns to his roots or thereabouts to guide the Pacers to the playoffs or thereabouts. But let's start with the games you're going to see tonight right here on TNT. Nowhere to go but up for Rick Pitino in Boston. The Celtics had their worst season ever a year ago, 15 wins. And they host the champs in less than 1 hour at Fleet Center. Let us check in with the guys who will call it for us. Dick Stockton and Hubie Brown at the Fleet Center. Welcome back to another season, guys.
And welcome back to you guys. And is it possible that Michael Jordan would be upstaged on an opening night? Well, in Boston he is because of Rick Pitino, the guy you mentioned. He begins the era for the Boston Celtics as head coach. And a lot of people are excited about bringing up the team from 15 wins. No secret, Hubie, to what the coaching style of Rick Pitino is going to be from day one.
They're going to give us Pitino ball, Dick, and that is play 10 guys a quarter, a lot of pressing and trapping after field goals and foul shot attempts. They live and die with the three-point shot. A lot of energy will be expended. The main thing is the team will get better as the year goes on. What they're looking for, 6 home games in their first 8. Can they get off to a good start? Tonight, Chicago, you've got to beat the press. And when you get the press beaten 2-on-1, 3-on-2, you've got to take it to the hole and score. It'll be interesting.
It will be, and of course the Bulls will not have Scottie Pippen. They have some problems of their own as they start on another NBA title deal. We'll see what happens here. It's been a hectic day, obviously, in Los Angeles. For that, let's go out to the West Coast and Bob Neal and Doc Rivers. Guys?
Thanks, Dick. Yes, it's not even dark in Halloween, and we've already had our first Halloween incident here in Hollywood, and it happened at the Great Western Forum. It happened this morning
as the Los Angeles Lakers were leaving the court and the Utah Jazz were arriving for practice this morning. Shaquille O'Neal, who's not going to be able to play tonight due to an abdominal strain in the muscle, in the stomach, is already making an impact on the game. As Greg Ostertag left the floor, Shaquille O'Neal confronted him on this floor right where we're sitting. Words were exchanged, and before anyone knew it, Shaquille O'Neal had slapped Greg Ostertag, who's 7'2", 270, and knocked him down onto the floor. Ostertag didn't get up. He's okay, but he didn't get up right then. And this thing, you wondered, how did it get started? Well, it started last year in the playoffs. What happened in the playoffs is, of course, Utah eliminated the Los Angeles Lakers 4-1. And Ostertag said, nobody talks about me, but Shaq's playing golf. I'm in the finals. Shaq took umbrage at such a comment and said he can't hold me. Ostertag is a scrub. Apparently, this has been stirring around in the mind of Shaquille O'Neal all summer long. Now, we talked to Shaquille and his teammate Kobe Bryant shortly after the incident happened, but Shaquille at this point was putting a spin on it as though nothing at all happened.
I'm a lover, not a fighter. Everybody is excited about the season. Words were said. That's about all that happened. Like I said, there's really no bad blood between me and Greg, and that's all.
I think it goes back to, the trash talking and all that stuff that happened last year throughout the playoffs and going into this season.
What about the impact?
Well, it's unfortunate, one, that what has happened here is Shaq has allowed something on the court, trash talking, which happens in every game, to seep out off the court, and he's taking it personal. That's the bad part. The good part is it's competition. It's ugly. It's Chamberlain and
Russell.
Bill Russell, perhaps?
Which one's Bill Russell? Which one's Greg Ostertag playing? Maybe we'll rethink of another two
yes.
that it might be. About tonight's game, Stockton's out with the knee 8 to 12 weeks, you probably know. Shaq won't play due to the abdominal muscle strain. Karl Malone has a sore finger on his right middle finger. Mm-hmm. Will he play?
Oh, he'll play. Karl Malone always plays. He's only missed 4 games in his entire NBA career. So he'll be out there. He wants to provide the leadership that John Stockton can't due to injury. Karl Malone will be there.
And by the way, our Brian Burwell talked to the NBA office in New York about the Shaquille Ostertag incident. The NBA said they will be looking into it, and nothing is expected to happen in terms of any kind of ruling until at least Monday. But we've got a lot of stories going for tonight's game. Let's go back to Ernie.
All right, thank you, Bob. And there's a lesson in there for all the film critics, anybody who panned Kazam. They'll be hanging out at the forum. Now, the Charles Barkley story, the incident in Orlando where he tossed that guy through a window, has prompted questions from the NBA and retirement talk from Sir Charles. Today in New York, he met with Deputy Commissioner Russ Granick to talk about his off-the-court conduct, and we learned about his on-the-court future.
Obviously, I want to play, and I'm going to play. There's obviously going to be some new guidelines in my life. I'm going to have a security guard anytime I go out. You know, that's unfortunate and sad. But every time I get arrested, it's embarrassing for me. It's embarrassing for the league. It doesn't matter what the circumstances are. It's just embarrassing.
Well, maybe the bodyguard thing will help that out, but is Sir Charles going to stay and just be a room service guy?
First of all, Ernie, I think that Charles was out of line by hitting this guy, throwing him through a plate glass window. I mean, he could have killed the guy. Charles has got to get that under control.
Well, I hope that the league does mandate that every time that Charles decides to go out, that he had the bodyguards, otherwise nightclubs, plexiglass.
How about the other thing now? I mean, you live in Los Angeles. Yeah. You saw the stuff in the paper through the playoffs and into the offseason between Ostertag and Shaq. Any surprise they went at it?
Well, you know, I think, first of all, the two situations are very different. I think that Shaq might have made a mistake. He didn't say that Ostertag was a scrub. He was just trying to say that I want you to scrub the floor, so he showed him how to get there.
Oh, for goodness sake. First of all, since when do players start reading newspapers? Yeah. I've never been a big fan of it. It was last season. This is a new season. Get over it.
Well, it's a good thing he has the abdominal pull, so he didn't really haul off and knock him down. Well, an NBA tip-off 97 continues. We're going to dive into the sea of opening night questions. Give me a for instance. Hey, the champs begin their defense with a major ingredient in their title recipe missing. What do they cook up without Scottie Pippen?
We all know that without Scottie Pippen, we're not a championship team, even with Michael and Dennis. We have to have Scottie.
And back home in Indiana, the Hick from French Lick takes his legendary basketball mind to the Indiana bench. Now, can his players keep pace?
He's very laid back, very confident, very much like when he was a player, but he just lets us play.
NBA Tip-Off 97 on TNT is brought to you by Motorola Pagers, with the Motorola Pager you know now, and by Nike.
Don't work too late. Tommy's better, so forget the drugstore.
Tape your favorite show.
So come straight home. We miss you. Love, Jack.
Motorola Pagers. To know, now. Motorola, what you never thought possible.
Dave Thomas is still looking for people who haven't tried Wendy's new fresh stuffed pitas.
Hey, Shay.
Yep.
I see here you haven't tried our pitas.
Oh, yes, I have. And they're delicious. So fresh. Now, I really like the one with the chicken and ranch dressing. I also like the garden veggies. Of course, my favorite's the chicken Caesar. Now, my daughter, she loves the classic Greek.
We stuff our warm, soft pitas with fresh vegetables and tender chunks of all white meat chicken.
Must be a different Peggy Shay.
Wendy's fresh stuffed pitas. Don't be the last one to try them.
I've got a problem. I love to read. So when I start a good book, I can't put it down. It doesn't matter what I'm doing. I have to keep reading. Then as soon as I finish, I can't wait to start the next one. I better get started.
Prepare for the first ever Nitro Original.
Let's move. Behind you.
Fire in the hole.
Terry Hulk Hogan.
Let's do it.
Assault on Devil's Island. Tomorrow night at 8 on TNT.
It's a nice thing the league does every year. Earlier this week, players like Portland's Kenny Anderson took part in the annual NBA Team Up Day. Chris Dudley spent some time in a New York after-school program reading to the youngins. Tim Hardaway put the hat on. He and Pat Riley lent a hand to the construction of a homeless assistance center in Miami. And recognize him with a hat, Gary Payton spent his day at a Seattle Children's Hospital. Good stuff this week, NBA Team Up. New season, same question. Is Chicago going to win this thing again? New season, new question. How are the Bulls going to do with Michael Jordan's wingman, Scottie Pippen, grounded for the start of the season? For the answers, there's only one place to go for Brian Burwell. That's the bowling alley.
After a great bit of investigative journalism, we have finally discovered the secret to the Bulls' championship success. Before they go to work with this ball, they play with this one. Just like on the court, the Bulls are knocking them all down. Hey, it's gotta be the shoes.
Hey, I can't do it unless the camera is.
The Chicago Bulls are used to bowling over the competition on the way to their five NBA titles, but the drive for number six may be the toughest yet.
What time is it?
This year is gonna be a struggle. It's gonna be a struggle for us out there.
We're not the same team, and we know that. And the last 2 years, we've felt invincible, and we showed it. We hardly ever lost. And I have a feeling this year is going to be different. We're not going to win so many games. It's going to be a bit of a grind.
The biggest challenge of all is starting the season without Scottie Pippen as he recovers from foot surgery that is supposed to keep him out until January.
Sure, we're going to miss him the first 3 months, you know, but I'd rather for him to do it now than to come April, May, and June, and Scottie Pippen can't play.
What would you guys miss the most about Scottie's absence?
Everything. I mean, you could point to any area of the game, and we'll miss him desperately. Rebounding, defense, scoring. ball handling, leadership. We'll miss him in every department.
You can't just throw Tony Kukoc in there and say beat Scottie Pippen or bring Scottie Burrell here and tell him to replace Scottie Pippen. You know, that doesn't happen. Collectively, we have to find individuals on given nights to expand their roles to cover for that loss.
Our team has been built around the fact that, you know, we have this 1-2 punch. The rest of the players are real good complementary players. We're going to have people do things they haven't been capable of doing in a while.
So now Jackson is in search of that delicate balance to winning, replacing Pippen's scoring in the short term without going back to the old days of Michael and the Jordanaires.
The tendency is that if Michael tries to take over a team right now without a score like Scottie, he can do as much damage as good. You know, and become a team that might be reminiscent of his early era in the NBA, where it's real tough to do anything else but just give Michael a ball and get out of the way, because he's going to go hell-bent for leather. We have to watch that that doesn't get to be, you know, something that has to happen just so that we win.
We all know that this is Jackson's last year in Chicago, and Jordan has made it very clear that if Phil leaves, he's leaving too. Yes, we have been teased a lot about retirements and such from these Bulls, but this time there's a sense that this really is it.
This is the last ride on the train, baby. You better enjoy it now.
We just try to enjoy the moment that we're going to be together, maybe the last time, and use that as motivation once we step on the basketball court.
In case you were wondering, Brian Burwell owns those bowling shoes, by the way. Replacing Scottie Pippen, it's going to be up to Kukoc, Buechler, and Burrell. You see what they combined for last year, the various numbers Pippen compared to the guys are going to try to take his place. Let us bring in the 13-year NBA veteran who honed his skills on Chicago's playgrounds, Doc Rivers. And Doc, the amazing thing to me about the Bulls' championship run is that they remain motivated. There's no slacking off in that department. How do they do that?
Well, I think they stay motivated because of number 23. I keep hearing this talk that the Bulls are not going to win it this year, and I missed the memo that Michael Jordan had retired, because if he hasn't, they'll be back, and they'll be right in the thick of things. I think this is another challenge for Michael Jordan. He wants to prove now not only are they going to win it for the sixth time, that this is one of the greatest teams in NBA history, but he can lead this team by himself if need be.
But for those who were saying maybe they're vulnerable, and I bring in Cheryl and Reggie here in this conversation too, that maybe during the playoffs there were a few chinks in the armor. Are there teams going into this season thinking, we can play with those guys?
Well, what's interesting, I spoke to Phil Jackson earlier today, and he's basically anticipated that the Bulls will get off to a slow start, but he really anticipates them gaining some ground in January. But he says, look, we're not worried about best record or even finishing at the top of the East. Their main concern is trying to get healthy down the stretch and try to defend their title.
How about, Doc, the minutes for Michael Jordan? Will Phil play him more because he needs that kind of production from him, or do you keep playing Michael the same minutes?
Well, it's easy to say that you will not do that, but I guarantee you if it's a one-point game and there's 10 minutes left in the game and Michael's on the court, you can't take him out, so you leave him in. He will probably play more minutes early in the season. Now, to counteract that, later in the season when Scottie gets back, maybe he can rest him a little bit. Michael Jordan does not need rest. He doesn't like rest. He's a tireless player. He wants the minutes. Whether he can handle it or not remains to be seen.
Thank you, Doc. We'll talk to you in a few hours out there at the Great Western Forum for Game 2 of our doubleheader. Reggie, to you now on the Chicago Bulls and the beatable factor. Or is this another Chicago year?
Well, you know, Ernie, I think that it's too much going on with the Bulls right now. Scottie being out, you know, Phil having problems. You know, Dennis Rodman hadn't even gotten to the thick of things. So I think the Bulls are in for a lot of problems this year. And remember that it takes two go-to guys to run that triangle offense, and they're going to be without one. You know, home court advantage through the playoffs is big to win it all.
Yeah, the Dennis Rodman factor there, too. And I was thinking the other day, he's the only guy in the NBA who would feel comfortable at both the Million Man March and the Million Woman March. He put that on his resume. So you've been paying attention during the offseason, folks. Do you know, for instance, where Sherman Douglas is playing this season? Started in Milwaukee, then to Cleveland, then to Denver, and just tonight wound up in New Jersey. You want more moves? Listen up. Between trades and free agent moves, more than 40 transactions have sent players to new teams, racking up more than 45,000 frequent flyer miles. Yeah, it's been another off-season of change. Among the biggies, Sean Kemp's reign in Seattle is over. He's in Cleveland. Terrell Brandon's a buck. Vin Baker's a Sonic, a three-way trade of over 4,600 miles. Chris Mullin's days by the Bay are over. Now he's getting his bearings in Indiana. Denver took a roll of McDice and sent Antonio to the Valley of the Sun. That's also where you'll find Cliff Robinson. Hardly recognized him without the headband. We had Mills on the move. Terry left Detroit for Miami. And Chris was dealt from Cleveland to Boston and then to New York. Don't unpack. Ryan Williams got a ring in Chicago and decided Detroit had a nice ring to it. And Mark Price has gone from Golden State to Orlando with his magic touch. But the mileage king, Rick Fox, who leaves the chowder behind in Boston for a taste of L.A. Showtime. We have to upgrade the Turner aircraft. That thing's looking just a little bit shaky. Reggie, you kind of like what the Bucks did in the offseason, huh?
I really like what the Bucks did. Terrell Brandon, Tyrone Hill, EJ, they got some scorn and some defense in that one. Also, I like the Orlando Magic. I like Derek Harper helping out Penny Hardaway because Derek Harper can play two positions. He can take a lot of heat off of Penny defensively and guard the two men. I like
you?
That.
Well, I got two other guys I think will have significant impact on their teams, but you guys are basically just going to have to wait till later in the show. A little tease there. Just a little tease.
You want to do the rest of it for me here? Yeah, that's fine. When we come back?
Too. Well, thank you.
Yes, Cheryl, as she mentioned, has some ideas on what you're going to see this year, including the Sonics getting a big bang from their former buck. And what Vin Baker's move to Seattle will mean. And then straight ahead, what other teams would like to have a piece of the rock. NBC's Peter Vesey on Mitch Richmond and other topics next.
I hate machines.
Huh.
Sorry, Rosie.
Why don't we go to the new Sprint store at Radio Shack, George? They have Sprint's easy-to-use products.
And the know-how of Radio Shack.
They even showed Astro how to use his mobile phone.
They could even help you, Mr. J.
Astro has a mobile phone?
Well, Rhonda.
The new Sprint store at Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers.
The aluminum in your car radiator is as thin as this sheet, and it's the only thing between you and a breakdown. But Prestone Antifreeze bonds with aluminum, forming a zone of protection against corrosion and temperature extremes. Protect your car in the Prestone Zone. And also, check out Prestone Low-Tox Antifreeze, specially formulated to give an extra margin of safety around pets and wildlife. Prestone Low-Tox. It's extra protection in the Prestone Zone.
Go to the net. Now connecting to the NBA. Welcome to NBA.com, the official website of the NBA. You have gained full access to all 29 teams and their players. Check out nightly scores and stats, read the latest NBA news, visit the NBA Theater and relive spectacular plays. Browse the NBA store, even enter a live chat session with an NBA player or coach. The online world of the NBA, only at NBA.com.
The Simpsons are expecting, so they came to Cable Dahmer Chevrolet Geo looking to trade up for a new Chevrolet with a little more room, but they still wanted something sporty. With Cable Dahmer's 8.5 acres of cars, trucks, and vans, plus special good neighbor financing, they had no problem finding all the space they need. Come see us at Cable Dahmer Chevrolet Geo Mazda on the Miracle Mile Nolan Road, Independence.
Evander Holyfield beat Mike Tyson, then he beat him again. He beat Foreman and Bo, too. He beat everybody. Everybody except IBF champion, Michael Moore. Holyfield, Moore, too. World Heavyweight Championship, one of four championship fights Saturday, November 8th, sponsored by Budweiser, live on pay-per-view from the Mirage. Evander, you beat everybody. Except.
Hurry to pick up your converter. Supplies are limited.
And it is time now to spend a few minutes with a guy who worked the last two NBA drafts with us and lived to tell the tale. NBC's Peter Vesey joins us now with the latest, what's going on around the league. And let's start, Peter, with Charles Barkley. Hey, he is going to play.
I don't think there's any doubt that Charles was going to give it up. I think he realized that he can only make so much per sitcom. And you know he's going to stick around. He met with the league today. And he brought it up, the fact that maybe he should have security with him when he goes out at night. I've got a better idea. Don't go out at night.
Let's talk trades a little bit here and what some teams are doing. How badly does Mitch Richmond want out of Sacramento, and is he going to be moved?
The Kings are not going to make a bad deal. Jeff Petrie, the president, general manager of the team, his job is on the line. He has to make a good deal. He doesn't want a big man. He wants a young shooting all-star. And that's why I believe the Lakers have the best shot of getting him by offering Eddie Jones in a package. The Miami Heat are trying. They also have a good chance of getting him. Maybe when Alonzo comes back, they can offer a little bit more. You know, maybe throw in Ike Austin with a shooting guard. But Petrie has to be able to sell it to his fans.
How about Rick Pitino's situation up there in Boston? Is he happy with the unit he has right now?
This man has buyer's remorse. He signed 4 free agents during the summer. He's already traded Chris Mills and Massenburg, and now he's trying to trade Andrew DeClercq. He tried to put him into a package in the last couple days with Chauncey Billups, the third pick of the draft.
How about the Philadelphia situation? Jerry Stackhouse, are his days numbered in Philly?
Well, I don't think so, because it seems like it's impossible to move him. Again, Philadelphia offered him for Mitch Richmond. Again, Sacramento does not want a guy at the end of his contract. They don't want to be in the same position that they were with Brian Grant this past year, and they lost him to Portland. So Stackhouse was also offered yesterday to the Nuggets for Brian Stith, and the Nuggets thought about it, and Rex Walters would have been in the deal from Philly, but then Bill Hanslick decided against it at the last minute.
Peter Vesey, as always, great talking to you.
Thanks, Ernie.
Have a great year. As if that is not enough information to cover, we have got even more, as promised, as she teased moments ago.
Oh, yeah.
What are we looking for this year? The divine miss end.
Most questions. A lot of surprises in the league, from gender-breaking officials to possibly the champs coming out of the West. Oh, anything could happen. But these are my things to watch this season. Women's referees Dee Cantor and Violet Palmer have broken another barrier for women in sports. The excitement of last season's WNBA and now their appointment shows the NBA is in the forefront of breaking stereotypes.
Our work will definitely speak for us. I think in time, our gender won't even matter. We'll just be known as NBA referees.
Look for the NBA scoring to go up from last season. More teams will be looking to run. Teams won't be relying so heavily on a three-point shot now that it's moved back, and the skills of the point guard will be shown because it's easier to penetrate. One point guard who will greatly affect a team will be the Charlotte Hornets newcomer, David Wesley. With his addition, the Hornets should not have to worry about Muggsy Bogues' health. Wesley gives them a scoring point guard to take the load off of Glenn Rice and Anthony Mason. Furthermore, the signing of Bobby Fields from Cleveland gives Charlotte a much-needed two-guard who can defend. Look for the Hornets to be a quiet terror in the Eastern Conference. Changing names have been about the only thing the Washington Wizards have done during the offseason. However, their talent plus their playoff experience in their first-round loss to the Bulls makes them a very intriguing team. The Atlantic Division will be up for grabs, and in order for the Wizards to be successful, they will need a big and consistent season from shooting guard Calvert-Chaney. Finally, the Seattle Sonics are my pick to come out of the West and possibly win it all. The addition of All-Star Vin Baker gives the Sonics a post-up game and someone who can force the double team. I also believe the Sonics' rebounding and defense in the paint will be bolstered by Baker's inside presence.
Yeah, it's the piece of videotape that will not go away.
Cheryl
Miller paid big money for that.
Suburban girl. Speak to the hand. Speak to the hand.
Was worth the price of admission. By the way, Reggie Theus with his thoughts on what to look for still to come. Coming up next, the latest chapter in the life of a living legend. Larry Bird was the foundation of 3 Celtic championships. Can he become the architect of a title contender in Indiana?
When we step on the floor, he has prepared us as well as anybody, and he's not over there yelling and screaming and giving direction. He trusts the guys that's on the floor, and we, in return, have to respond.
He bows to no man. But to bring back his only love, he'll have to battle a god of darkness. Arnold Schwarzenegger is Conan the Destroyer. Tomorrow night at 10 on TNT's Monster Vision.
Don't work too late. Tommy's better, so forget the drugstore.
Taped your favorite show.
So come straight home. We miss you. Love, Jack.
Motorola pagers. To know. Now. Motorola. What you never thought possible.
Sources, even the ones we share our homes with. Microscopic particles from millions of tiny dust mites may play a major part in aggravating allergies. Studies suggest electronic air cleaners can bring relief to many sufferers. A Honeywell Perfect Climate Specialist can upgrade your system.
In Kansas City, call Midwest Precision. In Overland Park, call Dick Ray, the master plumber.
Need a lift?
Galen Boyer's got it.
Need a start?
Boyer's got it.
And right now, Galen Boyer's got it all on sale. Like 98 LeSabre Customs, Big V6, AC, AM, FM cassette, and power everything. Plus clearance savings on every new car, truck, and van on the lot. During the Galen Boyer year-end clearance, it's all on sale now through Saturday. For service, selection, and unbeatable prices.
Boyer's got it!
Galen Boyer on the Miracle Mile, Nolan Road, Independence.
One of the new Chicago Bulls, Scotty Burrell, got him in a trade with Golden State. You look at the clock, under 28 minutes to go before we take you to Boston for game one of our opening night doubleheader, the Bulls taking on the Boston Celtics. Think Boston Celtics? Larry Bird comes to mind now. When you think Larry Bird, Indiana comes to mind. And you spent some time with the legend as he embarks on a new chapter in his life.
Yeah. I think after retiring and being a consultant for the Boston Celtics, the competitive edge and the desire to win began to work on Larry Bird. Now, since playing was definitely out of the question, Larry looked to his next option, to coach.
I think the incredible thing is you realize that this is Larry Bird coaching you.
Well, to tell you the truth, we're still a little bit awestruck. I think when we go to these other cities and play, the reaction that he receives when he walks from the dressing room onto the floor, it kind of gets us pumped up.
The novelty of Bird coaching will soon end. He will become just another coach in the NBA. Will the former superstar have the patience to handle losing?
Larry Bird knows that every guy on that team cannot measure up to him. He knows that. He's not going to try to make them be Larry Bird. All he wants is 125% every night. He wants effort. He wants guys to approach the game like he approached it.
It wasn't that long ago that Magic was coaching the Lakers, but it ended abruptly with Magic quitting in frustration, citing the attitude of the players. Magic said the toughest part for him when he was a coach was that he wanted to win more than the players. How do you handle that?
Well, there's no question we want to win. And you know, having the veterans on this team, that they want to win too. But what we have to do is prepare these guys every night to go out and put them in position to win. They play. It's a player's game. But as coaches, you got to have these guys mentally and physically prepared every night they go out. And that's our job. And if we don't do that, we're not doing our job.
Bird's job may be easier due to the veteran makeup of the team. Some of the guys played against Bird.
People ask me, what do you call him? Do you call him Larry? Do you call him Coach Bird? And I was like, when we played against him, I called him a lot of things other than those two. Watching his preparation before the game, realizing that it was no coincidence why he was doing the things during the game.
When I played with him that short time in the summer, you know, he was willing to give some advice, not much, because I don't think he wasn't sure if he's coming back. He doesn't want anyone using his stuff. But now, to be able to, you know, openly get his advice and education on a daily basis, has been great.
He's a player first and foremost. He's a guy that understands when it's time to back off, when it's time to push, what buttons to push, when to say what. He's been in our situation.
Bird didn't wait long to make his first acquisition. Veteran Chris Mullin, a deadly shooter who can take the pressure off of Reggie Miller.
We went out and got Chris Mullin because of the leadership. He's the type of player that can make plays for us down the stretch. We got him for his scoring and his playmaking, but we really got him to make plays at the end of the game.
It's been a great change for me, playing for Larry. Probably more importantly, playing with the guys that are here are just real professional, hardworking, you know, serious, and they just want to win and win together.
And so does Larry Bird. After winning three MVPs and three NBA championships, he's back in Indiana with one thing on his mind.
The fourth championship. Been eluding me for a while. I don't know. Basketball's been my whole life, and once my back healed up, I started thinking a little bit, and the only way I can get some competition is get back out here and get the guys together and go out every night and try to win some games. But, you know, once you win a championship, that's all you think about.
Larry Bird is coaching a bunch of guys who would love to accomplish just a minute fraction of what Larry accomplished in his career. The NBA titles, the MVPs, the All-Star game appearances. He had 12. His team has 9. Larry Bird, the new head coach of the Indiana Pacers. Let us get the take now of a guy who coached in this league for ages. Hubie. Hubie Brown is up there in Boston. What has Larry Bird gotten himself into here, and what is the biggest challenge, you think, that's going to face him this season?
Well, first of all, the big thing is to stay within his personality. Right now, he's not yelling at anyone. It's not his personality to do that. That doesn't make him a good coach or a bad coach. It doesn't make him better than the guy who was there before, because the guy who was there before, Larry Brown, had them in the Eastern Conference Finals 2 out of the past 4 years. Now, Larry did not inherit a bad basketball team. He inherited a team that, when healthy, Smits last year missed over 30 games, and so did Derek McKee. When this is a healthy basketball team, they are right there to get to the Eastern Conference Finals. They'll be in that kind of competition. So for Larry, he's on a honeymoon. The players are saying the right things. They're undefeated. We haven't thrown the ball up yet. And everybody's helping. What happens when they have the losing streaks? What happens when players don't play to their potential? What happens when they get key injuries, especially an injury to Smits? How will things work out then? That's when you'll evaluate it.
All right, thank you, Hubie. And Reggie, if you're a player and Larry Bird is going to be your coach, are you pumped up about that? Are you apprehensive because here's a great player coming in to be your guy?
Well, you know, first of all, Ernie, at first I would be very apprehensive because as a great player, you know, he didn't have to talk to anybody. Everybody talked to him. As a coach, you have to do a lot of coddling and talking to your players and finding out what they're thinking. I think as long as the players are saying that they love him and they want to play for him and he's not saying the wrong things, things are going to be all right early.
How's your brother liking it up there with
Reggie,
Larry?
Reggie said communication has not been an issue with Larry Bird. And he said, sure, what's not the love? I have a coach that has a better stroke and talks more trash.
What I like hearing from Larry Bird, too, is that he said, hey, if you're going to shoot the three-pointer in a game, I want you staying after and shooting 75 or 80 of them after practice.
Right.
You know, we had Cheryl's thoughts on what's going to happen this year, things to watch. And by golly, we now have Reggie Theus'
right.
take,
uh-huh.
and it's all yours, big fella.
That's Go. Right. Hey, how happy are you that the three-point line has moved back?
Ecstatic.
Ecstatic. I know I'm happy. Now, you're going to look at some coaches that are making big money that still aren't going to win big. Hey, the intriguing thing about the first part of the season, check this out. The Sixers' Larry Brown and the Celtics' Rick Pitino are considered great coaches. As a coach, Brown has had only 2 losing seasons in 25 years. However, the Sixers have had 6 straight losing seasons. For the miracle worker Pitino, he lost only 50 times in Kentucky in 8 years. Yet the Celtic team he's taking over lost 67 games last year. Boy, these guys have their hands full. Orlando's Penny Hardaway is looking to make a run at Michael Jordan's scoring title. With the addition of point guard Derek Harper and Mark Price, Penny moved to the 2-guard where he was highly effective in the playoffs versus Miami. With injuries to the Bulls, Scottie Pippen, and the Heat, Alonzo Mourning, the first 2 months are critical for the New York Knicks. They could grab a comfortable lead for home court advantage in the Eastern Conference playoffs. The NBA has returned the three-point line to his original spot where we used to bomb from back in the day.
It's 5 on the clock, 4 on the clock. Theis for three over Jordan. It's in, and New Jersey has a 5-0 lead.
Moving it back to 23-9 will benefit some teams, yet hurt the offense of other players. Look for the Indiana Pacers with sharpshooter Reggie Miller and Fred Hoiberg and newcomer Chris Mullin to bomb away this year with great effectiveness. In L.A., look for Kobe Bryant to have a breakthrough season. He put on a highlight reel in preseason, and defensively, the Lakers could lead the NBA in block shots and steals. Finally, the Suns may be the most talented 12-deep squad in the NBA. Their second team could probably beat the likes of Denver, Dallas, Golden State, and Vancouver on a regular basis. They will be a major factor in the West. Also, the real reason Kevin Johnson didn't retire, because he only needs 11 assists to pass me on the all-time list.
All I have to say is Jerry Colangelo used that to force KJ to come back. No way. I want to know how long that list is. Who's number 13, 14, and how did you get up there for passing?
6,500 assists.
They were more liberal with assists when they counted it back in the day. And by the way, how did we get that shot of Reggie Theis hitting a three over Michael Jordan?
Because
he carries the VHS with him wherever he goes and pops it in, even if you don't want to see it.
19,505.
Not a whole lot of lift off on the jumper, I might say. Not a whole lot of lift off.
Okay.
When we come back, they're running and jumping and dunking in San Antonio. The NBA's number one draft pick teams up with a healthy Admiral. Tim Duncan fitting right into the Spurs' big picture.
Still learning hotels and all that, but on the court, he's no rookie.
Ah, really?
No.
Cool.
His game is not like that.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, he probably appreciates that.
Hey, look! Got an energy spike.
Pull back!
Launch.
No!
All fighter squadrons launch.
Get us out of here!
Return fire.
Or freeze them!
Freeze them!
Babylon 5, coming exclusively to TNT, January 4th.
Hey, basketball fans, now you can try NBA Inside Stuff magazine free and get this incredible new NBA video, Furious Finishes.
Oh, yeah, boy!
With your Furious Finishes video, you'll get the most heart-pounding, rib-rocking action in NBA history with Reggie, Shelly, Zoe, the Rain Man, and so much more.
Stockton on the turn for a win.
And with NBA Inside Stuff magazine, you'll go inside the locker room and the huddle.
Yeah, I got every rebound. Let's get some music back.
You'll get the latest on your favorite players, plus exciting photos and an exclusive oversized poster in every issue. Call now for your free trial issue. If you like it, you'll get 5 more issues, a whole year of NBA action for over 30% off the cover price. And you'll get the video absolutely free with your paid subscription. NBA Inside Stuff magazine. Call now for your free trial.
Truckathon deals.
This is it. The biggest truck sale ever. Superior Chevrolet's Truckathon. With over 50 extended cab pickups.
Truckathon.
97 S10 pickups as low as $99.95. Just $99.95.
Truckathon.
97 Chevy Blazers as low as $19,995. Plus, Kansas City's largest selection of used trucks and 4x4s starting as low as $19,95.
Truckathon deals.
Superior Chevrolet, half mile east of I-35 on the Shawnee Mission Parkway.
There's a darkness inside all of us. Some have it under control.
What's underneath the front you put on?
Who do you want to know?
Others live for it.
We believe that murders are committed by the same killer.
West Block walks the tightrope between both.
Maybe it was you.
See why it's hard to track a killer when that killer might be you. Walk on the edge with Clint Eastwood in Tightrope. Sunday night at 8:30 on TNT.
Rookie Ron Mercer played for Rick Pitino at Kentucky. Now nearing his NBA debut. Game one of our doubleheader. Meantime, Shaq's in the house at the Forum.
Trick or treat, smell my feet, show me something, look to me. Little children, check all your candy. Make sure your parents check your candy before you eat it. Right, remember that?
experiencing all sides of Shaq today, the feisty and the fun-loving. At any rate, next week here on TNT, we got the Rockets and the Sun. It's Tuesday. On Wednesday on TBS, the Magic and the Bulls. And on Friday, the Magic and the Pistons, Chuck Daly returning to Detroit, followed by the Knicks and the Lakers. Missing some pretty big names here on opening night. Because of injuries tonight, we won't see Pippen or Zoe. Stockton won't play. Neither will Shaq because of the pulled abs. And Keith Van Horn, the New Jersey rookie, will not play. He's out 2 to 3 weeks with a sprained ankle. Others who will not play tonight because of suspensions, and I guess the biggest name there, you look at Allen Iverson, of course, for unprofessional behavior, suspended by the league. And Sean Kemp came off the bench during the altercation Vitaly Potapenko was in against Minnesota in the preseason. He'll sit this one out tonight. He'll make his debut tomorrow night when Cleveland plays at San Antonio. You know, it was back in 1836 that Davy Crockett and the boys put up a heroic fight but lost a home game at the Alamo. That was a common practice at the Alamo Dome last season, where the Spurs were 12-29 with David Robinson missing almost the entire year. But suddenly, there are great expectations in San Antonio once again. Here's Vince Cellini.
Better than advertised, Tim Duncan is the Spurs' reward for a season they would just as soon forget. In an era of me-first Gen Xers, Duncan's sign of rebellion? Practice shorts worn backwards.
He wants to learn. He doesn't know it all, but he has a lot of talent, and I'm glad he came to a team where he can just fit in.
I've been here for 8 years, it's taken me a while to learn a lot of the things, my lessons in basketball, and I'd like for him to, if he doesn't have to go through all those years, to go ahead and learn them as quickly as possible.
I really appreciate when someone come up and say, hey, maybe you should try this, and it works, because they know. So I'm really looking forward to them helping me every step of the way, and I wouldn't turn anything down.
With Duncan's highly anticipated debut approaching, expectations are high, but are they realistic? Can Duncan and David Robinson coexist? After all, only one player can play the five or center position.
I didn't always play five. I was in the five position because I was the tallest player. But I wasn't always a five. I was allowed to extend, push the ball up the floor, things like that, whatever. So I'm comfortable out on the floor. It's no big adjustment for me. I just play basketball.
I'm on the floor and they're calling four plays. And I'm thinking, four? What are you calling four for? I'm here. Five. Run the five plays. You know, I want to run a five post up. So it's a little different. I'm not used to having plays run for the other guy when I'm on the floor.
Because they're just as proficient on the block as they are at, let's say, 15, 16, 18 feet, they can spread the court, and it gives teams a heck of a problem because you've got to pay attention to both of them. And if you don't, one of them's at least open for the offensive board.
But the biggest X factor involved in the Spurs' potential success will be their health. Last year, 11 players missed a total of 347 games due to injuries, resulting in 24 different starting lineups and a mere 20 wins.
You know, the hardest thing I think for me was just not being able to do what I do. I mean, when you can't run, I'm a runner. I'm an athlete, and I couldn't do what I do. And just sitting there watching the games thinking, and I could be out there, I could be making a difference. And that was the most frustrating part for me.
NBA teams relished their trips to San Antonio last season, several adding insult to injury when facing the shorthanded Spurs. You see, it wasn't just about beating this crippled team, it was about embarrassing the Spurs. And the players haven't forgotten.
When I first came in the league, you have the good teams. They come in, they get their win, and they go about it, you know, professionally, businesslike. And now you have guys that come in and talk trash and do all this stuff, and that's just the way the league's changed.
Just come in and get the win and leave. Well, they came in and rubbed it in our faces. So obviously, well, that's in the back of my mind. That obviously, it's payback time. We have to right the ship. 20 wins and 62 losses didn't fit well with us last year. So this year, hopefully, we can reverse that record and at least get 62 wins back and really, you know, show some teams that we're really back and that we can compete for the title.
They took the biggest dip of all time. Now chances are they can make the biggest comeback of all time. Mm-hmm. What else does this team need, San Antonio, besides the Twin Towers?
Well, I think talent has never been the issue with this team. I mean, they have to really show me something. I remember them winning 62 games and getting punked in this Western Conference Finals. You know, it's always going to be a knock with this team. When it comes down to the crunch time in the trenches, do they have the to win it?
Well, not only that, but I think they obviously need to bolster their perimeter game, something that was really lacking last season along with the rest of their game. But I spoke to Coach Popovich. He's very excited, especially on the defensive end with the Twin Towers. They're not giving up a lot of second-chance shots, and the fact that they're into the transition early because of the two big guys, a lot of pluses for San Antonio right
now. And Pop hits most of his guys back. Chuck Person is still hurting, so is Charles Smith. They will start the year on the injured list. When we come back, it's a pairing made for Hollywood. What happens when the star of Booty Call meets up with a guy who has his share? Fox and Charles Barkley coming up next.
If there was a movie about Charles Barkley, what would it be and who would play you?
Who would play me?
Mr. Dave Thomas?
May I approach the bench, Your Honor? According to our records, you haven't tried our new pitas.
I guess I'm guilty.
Come try Wendy's delicious fresh stuffed pitas today.
These are great.
You know Charlie Small.
I do. He should be back in 2 to 3.
Don't work too late. Tommy's better, so forget the drugstore.
Tape your favorite show.
So come straight home. We miss you. Love, Jack.
Motorola pagers. To know. Now. Motorola. What you never thought possible.
No one taught me more about teamwork than my dad. They called him Mr. Mean because he never smiled. He didn't smile when he volunteered to coach the kids in the neighborhood. He didn't smile when he drove the team to every game. Or when he worked with kids for hours on his own time. He showed me anyone can make a difference if they just get involved. I'll tell you something else about my dad. He's got a great smile.
Team up with your community.
Yeah. Go ahead. Make my day.
He is the man who delivered the lines we know by heart and created the movies we've memorized. He has starred in over 40 films and directed 20.
I don't want to do pictures where I'm just repeating myself.
Though a man of mystery and few words, Clint speaks exclusively with TNT. Don't miss the world premiere of Eastwood on Eastwood, Sunday at 7 p.m., only on TNT.
Dave Thomas is on the coast, asking everyone about Wendy's new fresh stuffed pitas.
Your pitas are dreamy, Dave.
I thought you'd like them.
Wendy's fresh stuffed pitas, the only way to describe them is...
fabulous!
NBA Tip-Off 97 on TNT is brought to you by Motorola Pagers, with the Motorola Pager you know now, and by Nike.
And ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome back to the NBA the new head coach for the Pacers, Larry Bird!
Fans in New Jersey giving Larry Bird a nice hand as he takes the floor. And first bucket of the year, folks, comes in the Miami-Toronto game from the hand of Jamal Mashburn. And what's going on in Boston? Uh-oh, trouble if you're a Celtic. Michael Jordan showed up under 7 minutes before we take you to Fleet Center for the opener of our doubleheader here on TNT. So the question in our conference room was, how do we end the preview show on a lighter note? Well, Reggie wanted to do a commentary on the Hong Kong markets. Cheryl thought we should show that tape of her dancing at midcourt in its entirety. But we settled on a free-form conversation between comedian Jamie Foxx and sometime comedian Charles Barkley. They hooked up a couple weeks ago.
You know, I was supposed to be in on a, you know, on the team meeting, but they was like, you know, it's sacred and everything. They need one, you know, I guess they don't notice me right now, but you know, maybe, see, the thing about it is a lot of times, you know, they respect me, though. That's the cool part about it is, maybe right now, they just don't really feel like speaking and talking and everything, but, you know, maybe I should just go kill myself right now. It's just the fact that, you know, nobody really noticed me. A lot of people was yelling and stuff.
Sir Charles Barkley, who's the ugliest player in the NBA?
Who
was the ugliest player. It used to be Manute Bol, but he's gone now.
But Tyrone Hill is always the first. He's the first pick.
He's an MVP.
He's the MVP.
He's the MVU, most valuable. I don't want to get into it because I ain't big.
He's a good player though.
He's a real good player. Okay. Tyrone, you carry on. Allen Iverson. In the comments, got the hair braided. You
got a bad hairdo. Got great talent. Just got to learn how to play the game.
Learn how to play the
got
game.
Got great talent. Got a horrible hairdo.
You don't like that? The cornrows.
The braid look, that's horrible, man.
You don't dig it?
No, it was good when I was young.
Right, now it's changed.
They say everything always come back, but I don't think that's coming back.
You don't
back.
Think that should come
no.
back?
No.
I hear you. Shaq, dumb movies.
Bad movies. Real
okay.
bad movies.
Okay, Shaq did bad movies.
I am Kazam!
If there was a movie about Charles Barkley, what would it be and who would play you?
Who would play me? Somebody who's tall, dark, and handsome. Like a Denzel Washington.
Like
Sidney Poitier.
Sidney Poitier kind of old. I guess he played you as you got older.
Yeah, Denzel could start it, and Sidney Poitier can finish it.
Finish it, okay.
Because, right. You know, I am an international sex symbol.
I heard that. Hey, well, like I said, we're hanging out with Sir Charles. This is a pleasure for me and everything like that. And I'm just glad to be here chilling. And I'm glad, you know, you let me chill out with you.
Hey, my brother, you know I'm proud for you.
Thank you,
and
brother.
Just keep it up.
And, you know, I got a little TV show. Come do my show maybe one day.
Get anytime you need me. Anytime right, I can do it, I'll do it.
All right,
I told you that anytime.
All right, because, you know, right. I need you.
Yeah, I called early and, you know, got my little seats hooked up and everything. And Charles said he was going to hook the seats up. And I said it was special seats. But it's kind of far from, but I guess this must be the VIP section, yeah. Because there ain't nobody around me, you know. Yeah, this is VIP.
So Jamie Foxx and Sir Charles hanging out a couple of weeks ago. That was before all the Orlando mess and the meeting with...
Hey, Tyrone, don't worry about it, baby, because not everybody can be pretty, okay? It's about here and here.
That's right.
It's about the heart.
I think it would only serve Charles right that if they do make the movie, that Tyrone Hill should play Charles.
Absolutely. Tyrone Hill or Mr. Magoo.
Okay, let's talk, before we go here, a couple other things that happened in the league. One of the rules changes that I like a lot, you can't be jumping out of bounds and calling time.
You're always on top of
falling into that thing. Mm-hmm. Your thoughts on that rule? Good one to change?
I'm just glad that they finally decided to stop doing that. It really handcuffed the coaches when that happened.
I like the fact that they moved the line back and they also put the dotted line in the middle of the key, because those two things will open the game up. I think this year you're going to see bigger scores, more going to the hole, baby, and you get free throws. That's how you up the score in the
there
NBA.
There you go.
And to get free throws, you got to get the calls. Women referees.
All I have to say is everybody talks about Steve Javy. Hey, Steve Javy, don't worry about a step aside Violet Palmer. She's a quick team. Guys, don't mess with her. They're for real.
Do you have to change the way you approach the game?
I think the guys basically are just going to deal with them, because in the heat of the moment, it's about the game. And if they have to say something, I think they might think about it afterwards. But at the first time, bang, it's happening. Mm-hmm.
A lot of stuff going on. Opening night of the NBA season. Glad you're going to spend the night with us here on TNT. The Bulls and the Celtics, that's game one of our doubleheader. Michael Jordan and the champs opening up at home, by the way, tomorrow night. But they're in Boston tonight. The Jazz and the Lakers, game two of our doubleheader. You won't see Shaq because of the abdominal pull. You won't see John Stockton, but you'll see teams that met in the Western semis 1 year ago. We'll wrap it all up on Inside the NBA later tonight. So we're going to take you to Boston in just a couple of minutes for game one. The Celtics making their way to the court. The Rick Pitino era is about to begin. You're watching TNT. Thanks, folks.
Dave Thomas is still looking for people who haven't tried Wendy's new fresh stuffed pitas.
Peggy Shea.
Yep.
I see here you haven't tried our pitas.
Oh, yes, I have. And they're delicious. So fresh, you know. I really like the one with the chicken and ranch dressing. I also like the garden veggies. Of course, my favorite's the chicken Caesar. Now, my daughter, she loves the classic Greek.
We stuff our warm, soft pitas with fresh vegetables and tender chunks of all white meat chicken.
Must be a different Peggy Shea.
Wendy's fresh stuffed pitas. Don't be the last one to try them.
Hey, Dad. What are you doing up?
Reliving your mother's stuffed peppers.
Hartford again, huh?
What are you taking?
Tums, and I'm back for more.
You still taking that stuff? Look, Dad, take a Pepcid AC. One tiny pill controls acid all night.
So I can get some sleep.
Next time, take one before dinner, and you can stop heartburn before it starts.
Before it starts?
You don't see me suffering, do you?
What are you guys doing now?
Nothing, dear. We were talking about your peppers.
Peppers, yeah.
I got some in the fridge.
You can sleep heartburn-free with Pepcid AC.
This is NBA Live 98. Shoot.
These young guys have no fundamentals.
No fundamentals? What do you call a basic two-handed reverse photo op? A crisp, honey, did you see that bounce pass or a textbook big man camp drop step?
Hardaway on four.
Fuck.
Hey, ma'am, my crossover sweet and fundamental.
Right on. 1-888-MY-HOUSE. These guys need more fundamentals like they need more hops. NBA Live 98, the ultimate judge. EA Sports. It's in the game.
The following is an exclusive presentation of Turner Sports. In 1998, cable television's exclusive host for the 18th Olympic Winter Games from Nagano, Japan, and the 4th Goodwill Games from New York.
Tonight on TNT, four of the most storied franchises in NBA history meet in an opening night doubleheader. Rich in tradition, these teams have combined for an incredible 32 NBA championships with 29 most valuable players. They have set the standard that all others try to emulate, and their success on the court have been based on tradition. Center here in Boston is jumping with anticipation, and for good reason, as the NBA season opens with the Chicago Bulls, the reigning world champions, against the Boston Celtics. And this is the 14th year of NBA coverage on Turner Sports, coinciding with Michael Jordan's first year in the NBA. And good evening, everyone. I'm Dick Stockton, glad to have you with us for another big season. And we have teams at the opposite ends of the spectrum tonight. The Chicago Bulls, winners of 5 of 7 world championships, trying to squeeze out one last title for their dynasty. On the other hand, the Boston Celtics, with only 15 wins last year, trying to start a new era, and they have the coach that they wanted, Rick Pitino, and a lot of excitement. Well, Hubie Brown made the ultimate sacrifice. He went to Paris to watch the Chicago Bulls at the McDonald's Classic, and he's back, and he has seen the Bulls. They do not have Scottie Pippen. He's out. Tony Kukoc, a question mark. Dennis Rodman won't start. Therefore, Hubie, what kind of Chicago Bull team will we see tonight?
Well, we know that they're going to play great defense. That's a given. Michael Jordan must step up and give you playoff minutes and playoff numbers to carry the team during November and December. When they won 5 championships, 3 players always averaged double figures. Now, when you take Pippen's 20 points, 7 rebounds, and then the key, the number one assist man, 6 assists, out of the formula, Kukoc must step up, and then the key, Dick, will be who else will be the man. Will it be Harper? Will it be Longley? And then will it be somebody off the bench?
And Michael Jordan may need a big night tonight for the Chicago Bulls in the opener. The Boston Celtics, an interesting story. Your head would be spinning with all of the roster moves they have made and all of the changes at Rick Pitino. This is a Rick Pitino style as he starts another rebuilding program. What kind of Celtic team is this?
Well, I think you have to look at it and say it's the youngest team in the last 10 years. They only averaged 2.3 years of experience. Now, 10 guys are new. They only have 15 guys on this roster. 10 are brand new. The style of play, pressing, trapping, 10 guys a quarter. What they're trying to do, when you play young, develop the young talent, don't worry about mistakes, force turnovers so you get more shot attempts. Talent level is down, but intensity, defense, and camaraderie is going to be the key. This team, Dick, will get better as the season goes on.
And Hubie, with all of that, we still have Michael Jordan tonight, and Craig Sager is with us as our sideline reporter, and he caught up with Michael when he entered the arena before.
Michael, normally your biggest challenges are May and June. How do you carry this team now in November and December without Scotty?
I think we have to do it collectively. I don't think one individual is going to be able to do it. You know, I think we as a team, that's what the team is all about, you know. So we have to cover up for Scotty not being here. We know he's not here, but that don't mean we stop playing.
Toe surgery a week ago. How painful is it, and how restrictive will you be?
None. I am healthy. No problem for my toes. So I'm looking forward to it.
And you have any night jitters?
No, not yet, anyway.
All right, thanks. Good luck.
Sure.
The world is filled with obstacles, boundaries, and limits. Ignore them. Introducing the completely reinvented 205 horsepower Isuzu Rodeo. Neutrogena T-Gel Dandruff Shampoo, recommended number one by dermatologists. It works. Handles any type of dandruff symptom from mild to severe, controlling dandruff and other itchy, flaky scalp conditions. Neutrogena T-Gel Shampoo.
Nothing takes you out of the action faster than a diarrhea medicine that can let you down. But you can count on Imodium AD to stop diarrhea, often in one dose. Take Imodium AD, one dose relief you can count on.
Nathanson Creek.
Sea turtles. They bury their eggs in some tropical beach. When the eggs hatch, the babies find their way to the water and across miles of ocean. Now, we also have this built-in sense of direction when we're in our own shells.
Karin, the car navigation system from Philips Magnavox. It shows exactly how to get to where you want to go.
Man has finally caught up with nature.
Billy A on TNT is brought to you by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. And now introducing new Born on Dating. It's the day your bud was born. Is your beer fresh? By Isuzu, builders of the completely reinvented 1998 Isuzu Rodeo. Isuzu, go farther. And by AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts.
Opening night on Halloween for just the second time in NBA history. 1986 was the first. Ernie Johnson in Atlanta, joined by Cheryl Miller and Reggie Theus, the Bulls and the Celtics. Game one of our doubleheader coming up in just a couple of minutes. Only the Sacramento Kings have the night off. Everybody else is playing. We have got time for one quick highlight. Milwaukee playing Philadelphia tonight. A couple of newcomers paying off right here.
Hey, get used to seeing this. Terrell Brandon to Irvin Johnson. Bang!
But this is an ugly fall afterwards. Somebody will be icing down after the game.
Irvin Johnson able to get up. Ray Allen having a big quarter at 16 points in the first. In case you're just joining us, the NBA headlines. The Lakers' Shaquille O'Neal and Utah's Greg Ostertag had words at the forum this morning. Shaq decked the Utah big man with an open hand. The NBA is looking into it. Ostertag's okay. And after meeting with Deputy Commissioner Russ Granick today, the Rockets' Charles Barkley said he's not going to retire. He wants to play, and he'll start taking bodyguards with him when he goes out, which is a good plan of action for Charles Barkley. These guys didn't have a whole lot to talk about because time was limited, but they will have a bunch to say at halftime, and I will too. Remember, it's the Chicago Bulls opening defense of their title. Michael Jordan and the guys in Boston, to be followed by Kobe Bryant and the Lakers home against Utah. It's opening night.
Budweiser.
I can't believe they went with the frogs.
Louis.
Our audition was flawless.
Louis.
We did the look. Huh? We did the tongue thing.
Mm-hmm.
That was great.
Louis. Frogs sell beer. That's it, man. Number one rule of marketing.
The Budweiser lizards. We could have been huge.
Hey, there'll be other auditions.
Oh, yeah, for what? This was Budweiser, buddy.
No, no.
This was big. Those frogs are going to pay.
Let it go, Louis. Let it go.
To go farther. Go farther.
The completely reinvented 205 horsepower Isuzu Rodeo.
Too far.
happens every year in some of the most remote stretches of land in Mexico. And in the world of off-road racing, it's truly the whole enchilada. The legendary Baja 1000. A mountain of dust for those who can stand to eat it. And the end of the line for those who can't. That's why more drivers who challenge the Baja rely on the Duralast battery than any other. The same Duralast you can rely on in your car. Because it's the one we stock at AutoZone. The Duralast battery. Power you can depend on.
Right here, we negotiate on the court.
Somebody gonna come off the bench and give you a ref?
Yo, man, quit that brawl. What? Val? Show me some blood, baby.
And welcome back to the Fleet Center here in Boston. Rick Pitino's debut as head coach of the Boston Celtics, and they'll be facing this Chicago Bulls team. Ron Harper and Michael Jordan in the backcourt. Jason Caffey and Tony Kukoc starting up front along with the center Luke Longley. For the Boston Celtics, rookie Ron Mercer and the veteran Dana Barros at guard. Antoine Walker, Walter McCarty at forward, and Travis Knight at center. Three former Kentucky Wildcats who played for Rick Pitino will be in the starting lineup. The officials tonight, Steve Javi, Gary Benson, and David Jones, and we're set to go. And it's an opening night. Gary Benson, one of the officials, has his dad, Buddy, from Arkadelphia, Arkansas. He'll be seeing him work for the first time in his career.
Well, that's really a thrill, and especially when your son has been in the big time for 10 years.
First time, and he couldn't pick a better place. So the Celtics, whose fans have been starved for success, hard to believe after a team has won 16 world titles. And we're underway, and the tip is controlled by the Chicago Bulls, out of bounds. So the Bulls on offense first, and we talked about someone stepping up, and Ron Harper may have to be that man.
Well, you're talking about a guy who's averaged 17 points a game over his career. Now, what they're giving you right now is half-court pressure. They're matching up with you, but you must take it strong to the basket because they do not have shot blockers.
Jason Caffey misses from the baseline. The ball batted away. Caffey gets the loose ball and lays it in. Jason Caffey, who was the most consistent Bull in preseason, averaging 11 points and leading them in rebounds.
Major thing for Boston Celtics. They must take care of their defensive board. It is really a weakness.
And the first shot is missed by Walter McCarty, and the Celtics get the ball back. McCarty, who played in two games with the New York Knicks last year, came over in the major trade for Chris Mills just before the season started. Antoine Walker throws up the air ball.
For people who are sitting in this building, they're accustomed to watching Robert Parrish, Larry Bird, Kevin McHale post up. Right now, the Boston Celtics do not have a post-up player that you need to double-team. That puts pressure on your perimeter game.
And that's the style that Rick Pitino has. And it's not a style built for half-court offense. Tony Kukoc is fouled, and that is on Walter McCarty. McCarty, a former New York Knicks, came over with several young players for Chris Mills, who will help the Knicks for sure, coming off the bench. Jordan and a pushing foul is called against Ron Mercer.
That was an excellent call. You know, that was the old hand-checking rule, never mind the old forearm rule. This year, anytime that a player catches the ball at the offensive end of the court and faces you, you cannot put a forearm or a hand on him.
Good passing by the Bulls. Kukoc gets it into Caffey for the basket. Hubie referred to new rules, and we're going to talk about a few as we go along. And, of course, the three-point line has been moved back to 23 feet, 9 inches. That was the original distance, but in the corners, it is still 22 feet, which has been the distance all the way around in recent years. Missing from outside is McCarty. Celtics a little jittery, as you might expect with such a young team going against the world champions in this first quarter.
Well, anytime that you give the Celtics, the Chicago Bulls trouble, you've got to take the ball off the dribble, get to the hole, get down inside, and then crash the offensive glass.
2 minutes gone by in the opening quarter, and Luke Longley going to the basket is fouled by Walter McCarty, who picks up his second.
When you play against young team, the major thing is good ball movement. You see Kukoc fakes the jump shot, does a drop down pass to Caffey, who is running without the ball. Major thing tonight, when a team is pressing and trapping and running at you, what we call the old Carolina run and jump after Dean Smith, what you must do is take your time, give them ball fakes, and find key people moving to the front of the rim.
Walter McCarty with two fouls goes out of the game, and Bruce Bowen, who played in the CBA and one game with the Miami Heat last year, replaces him. A lot of new faces for the fans to get used to, as Longley missed the first free throw.
Well, they're high on Bowen. They really like his talent.
And a steal. Harper to a driving Caffey.
Oh, yes!
And Jason Caffey gives the Bulls a 6-0 lead. He's giving them a lot of energy in the early going.
The Bulls, one of the top three offensive rebounding teams in the league year after year. You cannot go to sleep in the backcourt.
Ron Mercer hits the first basket in the Rick Pitino era as the Celtics went 2.5 minutes without getting on the scoreboard. It's 6-2 now in favor of Chicago. And one thing you know, it's going to be an up-tempo game with Rick Pitino, win or lose. And an offensive foul is called against Michael Jordan.
Now, right now, you can see the Celtics get it. They fall asleep. Harper strips. And now watch Caffey come right down the middle and just nothing but mail it home. Big thing right now is that you block out, you take care of your defensive board, clear the ball, get it up the floor against Chicago and make them do transition defense.
Travis Knight with an air ball, fired that up one in a hurry. He's the tallest of the Celtics, the former Laker. Here's Michael Jordan picked up by Mercer. Tough assignment for the rookie Ron Mercer, having to deal with Michael Jordan, but you know he'll get a lot of help. Here's Kukoc, and he hits from the corner already. Good ball movement by the Chicago Bulls, and the score is 8-2.
Yeah, you like what they're doing. They're distributing the ball. Everyone is looking for the extra guy, and the big thing against scrambling defense, patience.
Well, if there's a team in the league that has patience, it's the team in red tonight. And Antoine Walker hitting from the line. He was on the line, so it's a two-point basket. And they're going to call Bruce Bowen with a foul on Tony Kukoc. That might have been a forearm.
Yeah,
foul.
What happens now, Dick, is when you're in the front court, meaning the offensive end, if a player catches the ball, you are not allowed to put a forearm on him until he starts to dribble towards the basket.
So that was an example of that new rule. Bowen committing the foul. Longley up and under, beating Travis Knight to the basket, and the Bulls looking sharp open up a 10-4 lead.
Now, when you were coaching that team that I remember back, those little shavers played for you, when a team doesn't have any shot blocking, please post up and go strong.
Of course. I learned that even before you talking that. Bruce Bowen on the follow. And it is now a 10-6 game. And there comes the full court pressure by the Boston Celtics.
Offense.
And there you go, an offensive hook called against Longley. He hooked him.
You had it before Jones. I like it. I think maybe you can do both jobs this year.
Give
okay?
me a big head here.
Now just watch this pass. Now watch as Longley fakes the pass. You see the hook right there? Nice. Good camera work and an excellent call by the trail official.
Purvis Ellison, the oldest player on the Boston Celtics, has come into the ballgame. Ellison, a 9-year veteran from Louisville, has come in to help the Celtics in the rebounding department. They have plenty of time on the shot clock, and a foul called. Antoine Walker was fouled by Jason Caffey. And Caffey committing the foul. So Caffey, Longley, and Jordan each with personal fouls, and the Celtics will inbound.
In the early going, Boston has showed no traps. They're matching up full court, playing man-to-man.
And another air ball. This by Dana Barros. Some of the better shooters on the Celtics. Way off the mark in the early going. Under 7.5 to go in the first. Kukoc slicing in and he traveled. So a Bulls turnover. Tony Kukoc, not in the best of shape, you'd have to say, as this season begins.
Look. During the exhibitions, Dick, he shot 25% from the field and 23% in three and 61% on the foul line. Is this Tony Kukoc, the guy that we're accustomed to being such an all-around player?
Caffey converting on the steal by Ron Harper, and Jason Caffey has 8 of the Bulls' 12 points. They've doubled the Celtics score. Nearly 5 minutes have elapsed in the first quarter. The Chicago Bulls are 6 of 7 from the field, off to a head start in a big way. Mercer driving the basket. Bowen with a good fake on Kukoc. Couldn't bank it in. Rebound Longley.
You know, in the early going here, I think the team switched shirts because the guys in red are stealing the ball and scoring on fast break opportunity.
Harper for three, and the ball is tipped away, and a loose ball foul is called against the Chicago Bulls, and it'll be the second on their starting center, Luke Longley. But would you believe it? Michael Jordan has yet to take a shot nearly halfway through the opening quarter.
GH4, taking the floor, here to score. Triple-double, no trouble, I got game galore. Watch the turnaround jumper, watch me come like thunder. Is it the shoes you wonder? Grab the bound, dish the pill. Grant Hill coming through, displaying ultimate skills. GH4, owning the paint, leaving you right where you stand. Moving too quick, you're too late. I'm going hard to the rack. Your game's whack. When I attack, stay back, way back. GH4 by Fila, change the game. The game.
Prepare for the first ever Nitro Original.
Let's move. Behind you.
Fire in the hole.
Terry Hulk Hogan.
Let's do it.
Assault on Devil's Island. Tomorrow night at 8 on TNT.
The game really is a lot like jazz. You can take a jazz quintet and actually liken it to five people on a basketball court. The point guard would be like the piano player, because in most bands, the piano is like the brain. Then you have the power forward, which is like the drummer. I think that small forward position, I'd have to give that to that tenor saxophone. But I think if I was a coach, I wouldn't put me in the game. I play a good anthem, man.
Get ready for a thrill ride inside the NBA. From the jams to the slams and all the bombs from three-point land. Sports Illustrated and CNN team up for an insider's look at this week in the NBA. Sunday, 11:30 p.m. Eastern on CNN.
And we want to welcome the viewers on CNN tuning into this opening day battle between the Bulls and the Celtics. Dick Stockton, Hubie Brown, and Craig Sager here. The Bulls lead 12-6. They've shot 6 of 8, and Michael Jordan has yet to take his first shot of this new season in the Boston Celtics under their first-year head coach, Rick Pitino.
Well, Michael, we know, is just playing within. He's not forcing anything. They have excellent ball movement. They're getting easy plays out on the fast break. I'm surprised so far. We've played almost 6 minutes. Oh, by the way, here he is. He is back, and they need him.
Dennis Rodman.
I'm surprised that we have not seen one trap as of yet by the Boston Celtics. All they're doing is matching up, chasing you, but they're playing the straight man-to-man.
So they're playing possum as far as the trap, because they knew the Bulls would expect it. Ellison throws the ball away on a turnover. That is the fourth turnover by the Celtics. So Dennis Rodman, who did not play in any of the preseason games and just signed his contract, had a problem with the incentives. But as Phil Jackson said, we need his fire, and that's why he's in the lineup and eventually will be the starter, of course, at power forward, the top rebounder in the league.
Well, last year, Jason Caffey started 19 games in the absence of Rodman and did an excellent job.
Here's Michael Jordan with his first shot of the year, and Ron Mercer gets the rebound. A lot of athleticism on the Boston Celtics, and that's what Rick Pitino's banking on. Right now, we're going to send our CNN viewers back to the CNN Center in Atlanta, and Ron Mercer with a 50 move, basket counts, and a foul. Mercer with his second hoop. That was Walker with the hoop.
This is a very nice move by Walker. Now just watch how he fakes in, comes baseline, gets a little away with a little bit of a push into the chest of Caffey. Caffey's looking at the referee and was kind of surprised that he did not get the offensive call.
Caffey picking up his second personal foul. D. Brown and Chauncey Billups. Billups, the top draft pick by the Celtics. The third pick from the University of Colorado. He has struggled so far in preseason, has come in the game. So a new backcourt for Boston. Walker misses his chance for a three-point play. Caffey in the forecourt. The way to beat the trap, as Hubie has mentioned.
That's right.
Get that pass up in a hurry. Yep.
Take it to the basket.
Celtics get it back. Trailing 12-8 here in the first quarter. We have 5:38 to go.
This guy can score.
Walker misses. Kukoc was defending, and Michael Jordan with the rebound. Jordan off to the slow start. But when the final box score is he'll have big numbers. Gets the first basket and draws the foul as well as he eased into the scoring column.
With the new rules of no forearm on a dribbler face, just watch this now. See, he can get a running start, and this is just an acrobatic shot. Michael at his best. See, when he gets the step, there's nothing that Bowen can do about it. He's taking it strong to the basket. And the Celtics, the coaching staff, are very impressed with Bowen, the young man. They really think that he is going to be an excellent defender.
Foul was on Purvis Ellison, and Jordan makes good. Took Michael Jordan 6:35 to score his first points of the season, and he got three of them. So it's 15-8 now in favor of the Chicago Bulls. Travis Knight playing up on top, and a great deny defense by the Bulls, and causes another turnover. Here is Kukoc. Bowen is all over him. Here is a post-up against D. Brown. Michael Jordan is fouled as Travis Knight came into the picture, and a hard foul on Michael Jordan.
Oh, that was just a beautiful ball fake by Michael. He saw the double team coming, and he gives the ball fake. Now, just watch the right of your screen. You're going to see Michael come in here. Now, he sees him coming, gives the pump fake, takes the hit, but he was hoping that he could get the shot off but with a little bit better a better look at the basket so he could possibly have made three-point play.
Rick Pitino took two different teams to the Final Four, Kentucky and Providence, and of course Rick with the title in 1996. Three Final Four appearances for Kentucky in the last 5 years. And this, of course, his second NBA go-around, his first with the New York Knicks. Also assisted Hubie Brown for a couple of years in New York. Chauncey Billups misses from the perimeter, and Jason Caffey clears. D. Brown is guarding Michael Jordan with 4:40 to go here in the first. Kukoc falling away, hits. Kukoc now with his second basket.
That's the telescreen. That was just a beautiful guard around, Dick. Anytime that they can't run their triangle, they come back to the top and run a nice guard around play.
Bowen is knocked down, but no foul. Tipped away and a steal by Jordan. And Michael with his first dunk of the season.
Well, you know, sometimes we have a tendency to forget he led the league in steals on three occasions during his career.
A perennial all-defensive selection, and a timeout is called. So the joint started jumping, but it's quiet now.
Now just watch Michael play that passing lane. There's no one better in the league because he gives you that 6'6", long arms, and the quickness.
The world is filled with obstacles, boundaries, and limits. Ignore them. Introducing the completely reinvented 205 horsepower Isuzu Rodeo.
You can't imagine your life without them. How about theirs without you? Who's your insurance agent?
State agent Roland Woods in Independence, or Don Adams in Lee's Summit.
Being in good hands is the only place to be.
Honey, it's time.
It's time.
Better get makeup.
Give your car a rebirth. Maaco has 7,000 oven-baked colors, a nationwide warranty, and ambassador paint service for $189.95. Breathe easy and say, uh-oh, better get Maaco.
This program is authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the National Basketball Association. Any publication, reproduction, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the express written consent of the National Basketball Association is prohibited.
To this point, the Bulls have taken the wind out of the opening night sails of the Celtics, 21-8. Talked about the rule changes. The three-point line has moved back And a couple of others, Hubie.
Yeah, it's over a foot longer than it was a year ago. Now, no charge areas, that half circle. It's a 4x4 foot area. And if a defensive player has 1 foot in there or is standing, he cannot get a charge. You may not call a timeout now if you are flying out of bounds and your body breaks the line. You cannot call a timeout. The referees will ignore you.
Scott Perrell, who was acquired in a deal with the Dickie Simpkins, has come over and is in the lineup now for the Chicago Bulls. And Burrell committing the personal foul. Burrell played with Charlotte and Golden State and has been injury prone in his career. Played his college ball in the Big East at Connecticut, as did Travis Knight. And Bowen goes up on a good block, recovers, tries to tip it in. Good second and third effort by Bowen. And it's tipped away and finally put in. No, Antoine Walker misses. And a great save made by Dennis Rodman into the hands of Michael Jordan. And Michael Jordan finds Kukoc in the corner. Hey, you know why? Pitino likes Bowen now. Tremendous battling inside, even though the Celtics did not come away with any points.
Okay, right there.
Got five on the shot clock for the Bulls, and traveling is the call against Ron Harper.
The early going right now, we have not played 9 minutes. We are seeing sloppy basketball at both ends of the floor. We're seeing quite a bit of traveling with the Chicago Bulls. A lot of players are using their forearms, so we're getting a lot of unnecessary foul calls.
We are getting that. Want to welcome our viewers from TSM north of the border in Canada. Boston Celtics, Chicago Bulls, opening game of the season. Antoine Walker misses the three-pointer, and Dennis Rodman gets the rebound, his third. We have not had a three-point basket yet in this game with 3 minutes to go in the first quarter, so the line obviously has made some difference. Normally, we've had a flurry of them now, and a pushing foul by D. Brown against Michael Jordan. Very tough to go against 23 anytime.
Well, D. Brown's given Michael 4 inches, and that time he got caught behind him. He was trying to get in front. That's a smart move. Anytime that the Bulls post up a guy in the triangle, front the man in the low post and force them to go back to the top of the circle and run their guard around stuff.
Michael Jordan, who did not score for the first 6.5 minutes, hits the free throw. He has 8 points. He and Cappy lead the team with 8, and the Celtics bring in John Thomas, rookie from Minnesota, who came over along with Walter McCarty and Dante Jones in the trade for Chris Mills with the New York Knicks. Dante Jones, by the way, who played at Mississippi State, suspended for this game because of his participation in the bench clearing situation with Miami in New York last year in the playoffs.
Now, right now, you saw the Bulls in their full court pressure.
Chauncey Billups with a basket. First basket for Billups, the number 3 pick. Winding down to 2.5 to go in the first quarter. The Bulls lead it 22-10. Kukoc gets 3 inside, and the Bulls are getting loose under the basket.
Well, all they're doing is running without the ball, Dick. They're staying within their triangle, but all of the action is away from the ball on the weak side of the floor.
D. Brown coming off the screen, off the backboard, and Dennis Rodman with another save. He has made several of them in this first quarter. Kukoc working against the taller Travis Knight. Here's Jordan as it batted away by Thomas, who makes the steal. Loose ball. Thomas still battling, and it's last touched by the Bulls.
Now, this is the third time that the Chicago Bulls have turned over the Boston Celtics in the backcourt after they have intercepted a play. Now, just watch this. This is a beautiful block, and as the ball goes down, they have possession of the ball. Boom, from the rear, this time Rodman.
And it's going to be Chicago ball as it was last touched by John Thomas. Burrell inbounds. Randy Brown has come in. Very reliable backcourt performer. Rodman has 4 rebounds of the 10. Rick Pitino telling us before the game, Hubie, that rebounding is going to be critical if his team is going to stay in the game. And right now, the Bulls have had the edge.
They have a very young team here, Dick. A lot of guys 6'10", 6'11", 7 foot, except they do not have any weight. There isn't any power here. So you have finesse and you have quickness, which is great for the running and the pressing and the trapping. But when you talk about NBA against a team like the Bulls, one of the perennial top offensive rebounding teams in the league, it's body on body that counts.
Speaking of bodies, here's Dennis Rodman working against Thomas as he hits the short jumper. Dennis Rodman is focused and not fully in shape. You wouldn't know it by the way he's played. Here's a steal by Randy Brown. Phillips lost it, and it's tipped
in. Oh, that was goaltending. Oh, my.
Well, they did not call it.
Yeah, well, I'm calling it.
Okay.
You refereed the one call before I'm refereeing this one. That ball was not totally off the cylinder.
Kukoc with the tip in. The Bulls are on a 16-2 run and lead it 28-10, an 18-point lead. Their biggest lead of the game. And firing away and hitting Ron Mercer, who is part of Kentucky's NCAA championship team a couple of years ago.
Now keep an eye to the left of your screen. Brown's going to miss this layup. Here comes Kukoc. Now just watch this ball as it is. See, the ball is over the cylinder. You're not allowed to touch it. Nice pass.
And here's Kukoc with another easy jam. So the Bulls are breaking the trap easily and now lead it by a score of 30-12. The Celtics are shooting under 30% and have turned it over 8 times.
Well, first of all, the shot selection at this end of the floor.
Oh, another steal. Here's Kukoc. He's got Brown, and Randy Brown lays it in. So the Bulls are shooting in the 70s tonight, but they are layups, an easy one.
Oh, I'm glad you underlined the layups. All right.
I don't want people to think they're hitting the perimeter.
One team is running a layup drill, and the other team is shooting jump shots. Okay, I think the team that's running a layup drill is going to be ahead.
Chauncey Billups. This is a three.
Nice pass.
And 5 rebounds for Rodman.
I'll tell you what happened. Yeah, Scotty Burrell right time. That time, slowed down on Dennis. Now here's a nice move, a nice interception by Kukoc. And then once again, total unselfish play. And the Bulls are really running the floor well tonight.
And Hubie, now they have brought in Steve Kerr, who is the hero in the 6th and deciding game. He got the pass from Michael Jordan and hit the key shot to beat the Utah Jazz. He has come in the game as D. Brown. 12 and 11 seconds remaining.
Oh, another
on the
steal.
Shot clock and another steal.
Oh, my.
The Bulls are making this look easy. Kukoc misses a three. Barrows gets the rebound. It up and is short. The Chicago Bulls under Phil Jackson trying to win their third title, a three-peat for the second straight time, leading the Boston Celtics by 20 after one.
Go ahead, make my day.
He is the man who delivered the lines we know by heart and created the movies we've memorized. He has starred in over 40 films and directed 20.
I don't want to do pictures where I'm just repeating myself.
Though a man of mystery and few words, Clint speaks exclusively with TNT. Don't miss the world premiere of Eastwood on Eastwood, Sunday at 7 p.m., only on TNT.
Budweiser.
I can't believe they went with the frogs.
Louis. Our audition was flawless.
Louis.
We did the look. Huh? We did the tongue thing. That was great.
Louis, frog sell beer. That's it, man. Number one rule of marketing.
The Budweiser lizards. We could have been huge.
Hey, there'll be other auditions.
Oh, yeah, for what? This was Budweiser, buddy. No. This was big. Those frogs are going to pay.
Let it go, Louis. Let it go.
They came to our planet. They destroyed our cities. But on November 7th, they'll learn they messed with the wrong species.
Shoot them!
Starship Troopers, rated R, opens everywhere November 7th.
So guys, what do we want to do this weekend?
Let's go to the beach.
It happened at 10 till 6 on a Tuesday night.
Okay,
just before the steamed carrots were served.
Guys, it's important. Yes, this is Louisa. What are you saying?
A phone call she would always remember.
We got the house. We got the house.
For a free guide to help you on the path to homeownership, call the Fannie Mae Foundation. We're showing America a new way home.
Start of the second quarter here at the Fleet Center. Dick Stockton, Hubie Brown, and Craig Sager. The Chicago Bulls leading 32-12. Six turnovers. And look at that turnover story, Hubie. What are your impressions of the first quarter?
Well, to me, I'm kind of shocked at the offensive end of the floor. Boston has 10 turnovers. Chicago Bulls are really not pressuring them or getting out and denying. They're just throwing the basketball, you know, right to the guys in the red shirts, and also bad passing angles on anybody posting up. I have just been totally shocked at the lack of defensive pressure by the Boston Celtics. They're shooting 27%, 10 turnovers. They're holding their own on the boards.
Andrew DeClercq, another pickup by Rick Pitino, who had played at the Golden State, has come on, number 45 to start the second quarter. Antoine Walker with a turnaround, doesn't drop. And there's Walter McCarty, the basket will count, and a foul. So Walker, McCarty, Barrows, D. Brown, and DeClercq start for the white-shirted Boston Celtics in the second.
Well, in Antoine Walker and McCarty, you have two really talented young players at your forward position. McCarty has a lot of hop, and by getting traded from New York to here, he's going to get an opportunity to get minutes and shot attempts. And it's good because he's a hard worker and he's a good, nice young fella with a great attitude.
Played a total of only 4 minutes in two games for the Knicks in his rookie year, a veteran club. Scott Farrell with Dennis Rodman, Luke Longley, Randy Brown, and Steve Kerr. Michael Jordan starts the second quarter on the bench. He scored 8 points in the first. Kukoc also on the bench had eight, as did Jason Caffey. No basket and a pushing foul against DeClercq. Let's give you an idea what's coming up on Turner Sports as we get this NBA season underway. Coming up next, the Jazz and the Lakers. And Ostertag and Shaq went at it today. You know about it. You'll hear more. Next Tuesday, the Rockets and Sonics in Seattle. And next Wednesday, Hubie and I will be at the United Center as the Orlando Magic and Chuck Daly go against these Chicago Bulls. Luke Lawley can't convert. Dana Barrows winds up with it. And into the low post. And Antoine Walker with the turnover. That's the 11th turnover by the Celtics.
Oh, the offensive foul. Good call. Good call. Luke Longley just shed Dana Burroughs. Dana Burroughs is only 5'10". And he went down in there to double team Luke Longley. Catch an eye to the right of your screen. Now watch what happens here. See, he holds his arm and he just sheds him like a big bear in the woods. Get out of here, will you please?
A big bear in the woods.
That's
okay.
Right. Oh, boy, he's a moose.
That's the third foul against Luke Longley. Walker double teamed inside. Antoine Walker loses it again out of bounds. So Walker and the rest of the Celtics struggling. Antoine Walker, a top rookie last year, leading them in scoring. Luke Longley will go to the bench, and Tony Kukoc replaces him. Longley with three fouls, scored only 2 points. Bulls have been able to get the ball up court with ease against the Celtics defense so far in this first half.
Well, they've only actually trapped one time so far in the backcourt.
Rodman missing, and the rebound by McCarty. Crowd, not much to cheer about yet. Here is Walker. Crashing the boards was DeClercq, and here comes a three-on-one break for the Bulls. Kerr tries to dish it off inside. Last touch by the Celtics.
I'm Randy Brown. I say something to Steve Kerr. Steve, get the ball up the front, because he had a passing angle, and he didn't give it to him. And if he would have passed the ball up front, he would have made the defense move, and then he would have gotten it back for a nice, easy layup there.
There's the shooting story as Michael Jordan comes in for the Bulls, and Ron Mercer coming in for the Celtics, who have shot just 27%.
And add on 12 turnovers on top of that.
That's why it's 32-15. It's been all Chicago. Brown coming off the screen. Randy Brown in and out. And Walter McCarty with another rebound. Good pass inside and at the basket by Ron Mercer. So Ron Mercer now into the scoring column has his fourth point. Yeah. Jordan double team. The open man is Brown. Good pass to Scott Burrell. Drives to the hoop. Batted out of bounds. And it's a great defensive play by the Celtics. Last touch by Chicago.
I agree with Dennis Rodman and Scott Burrell. I honestly thought that ball went off of a white shirt out of bounds.
Youngest team in 10 years in the NBA. Hubie reported at the top of the game, and they've got to go against the two-time defending world champion Chicago Bulls, looking for their second three-peat. To Clark, threw the ball away as Barros was not there. Another turnover against Boston.
Well, you can see Rick is in a state of shock, mainly because they continue to pass the ball to the guys in red shirts or to the people in the first row.
Rocket Sonics, Tuesday night at 8. The NBA is on TNT.
The moral of the story? Get the world's fastest sport utility vehicle. Introducing the Grand Cherokee 5.9 Limited. Get low 4.8 APR financing or get great lease rates.
Kansas City, are you ready? Let's get ready to rumble! Kansas City is rumbling about Jack Henry's fabulous selection of Hugo Boss menswear. In Kansas City, there's only two places you'll find world-class customer service and the distinctive style that is Hugo Boss. Jack Henry on the Country Club Plaza and Peter's Clothiers in Overland Park. Kansas City's undisputed champion of fashion and style.
He wants a new Mazda. She wants a used Mazda. So how did they find happiness? They went to Cable Dahmer Mazda in Independence, because Cable Dahmer Mazda emphasizes both new and used. A big selection of new Mazda trucks, minivans, and the Miata, and a big selection of high-quality late-model used cars, foreign and domestic, with nice people to help you. So if you're looking for new, but you'd rather buy used, or vice versa, see both new and used at Cable Dahmer Mazda on the Miracle Mile, Noland Road, Independence.
Ernie Johnson in our Atlanta studio. Larry Bernstein, nothing to this coaching thing. We have an early sighting of a supporter on the floor. It belongs to Chris Gatling, courtesy of Reggie Miller, who had 22 points in the first half. Indiana with Larry Bird at the helm, 57-48 over the Nets at the break. Reggie, 22 in the half. Back to Boston.
All right, Ernie, thank you very much. The place where Larry Bird became a legend, right here in Boston. Parquet floor and all at the Fleet Center. Celtics outscoring the Bulls 5-0 in a little more than 3 minutes of the second quarter. They're spinning a second quarter shutout, Hubie.
Well, anytime that you play helter-skelter, full court pressure and that, you play games in peaks and valleys. Now, right now, in spite of shooting less than 30%, 13 turnovers, you look at the clock, they're only down 15. And we're still, you know, there's plenty of time to go here. They just have to take care of the basketball and get higher percentage shots.
So they're only down by 32-17. Barros misses a guy and drops in.
That's
so our
it.
First three-point basket of the season here, Dana Barros, who's known for that, hits it from the field. So despite 13 turnovers in 16 minutes, the Boston Celtics are down by only 12. They trap Michael Jordan.
See, the clock is down now. They're inside of 11 seconds.
Celtics have outscored the Bulls 8-0 here in this quarter. And there's Randy Brown misses, but Scott Burrell with the follow, and the Bulls finally get on the scoreboard with nearly 4 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. They lead it 34-20. Don't forget, Jazz and Lakers coming up next, opening up on TNT. McCarty misses, and of course the young players will rush their shots. They won't have the same kind of patience the Bulls will.
No, and you know what, they play in peaks and valleys, like we said, they're in spurts. Now here's your shot. Just watch the weak side. See, any time that you're trapping, you're running at people, and you are allowing weak side offensive rebounding, and that was a perfect example of that right there, Dick.
Burrell on the Bulls. What do you think that looks like?
Well, if he stays healthy, it's an excellent addition. He has a lot of skills of Scottie Pippen. Because he's about that size, he can defend. He's a good three-point shooter and a slasher.
On the curve, miss. Here come the Celtics. Antoine Walker. And it looks like the Celtics have settled down a bit here in the second quarter. 7:20 to go. Here is Ron Mercer in the lane with a wild shot attempt. Gets the rebound and is fouled. Tell you one thing about the Celtics, they keep battling.
Well, they keep fighting, and they had nice ball movement at times. But, Dick, they're taking poor percentage shots. And you guys say everybody's hustling. This is a nice move by Mercer. But in this game tonight, they're getting into the painted area. When they get in there, if you notice, every shot is challenged. That might not happen in practice, but when you play the Chicago Bulls, they challenge every single shot.
Mercer, who played at Kentucky for only 2 years, Walker, also a two-year player. Walter McCarty played all 4 years at Kentucky. Burrell goes out, replaced by Ron Harper. That last foul was on Tony Kukoc. And Ron Mercer misses both free throws, gets the miss, and gets the basket. So he got two the hard way. And the Celtics trailing by 12 once again, 34-22.
Get out from behind the basket, Dennis, so that opens up for the long lobs.
Mercer just missed the steal on that inbound pass against Travis Knight. Michael Jordan with a great move. And he gets the ball back on the loose ball. He's going to go for two more. And not this time, although Ron Harper challenged that one.
I'm sorry, but I have to say this again. The Chicago Bulls are playing like I thought the Boston Celtics would play defensively. They have all of these steals. They have 9 steals. Here you go. There's your score. Now watch what happens. They throw the ball in bounds. Boom. Chicago steals it again. That is their 5th steal in the backcourt.
This Bulls team thrives on challenges, and of course the challenge they have is to go without Scottie Pippen for at least a month and a half. An offensive foul has been called against Walter McCarty. That is his 3rd foul of this game, and it comes with 6:25 remaining in the second quarter.
Well, you know what happens, Dick? To keep an eye on this. He hustles real hard, and then he steps. He lost his balance, and he went right into Dennis Rodman, and then Dennis Rodman goes for the flop and gets the call.
As he would.
Yes, of course.
McCarty to the bench with 3, and Bruce Bowen replaces him. Chicago Bulls playing without Scottie Pippen, who, by the way, may be back before January. They say possibly on Christmas Day. He's showing a quick recovery. He just had foot surgery 3 weeks ago, and he may not miss the first 2 months. That would be a great break for the Bulls if Scottie Pippen were to get back sooner. Tony Kukoc with the offensive foul. That's his 2nd of the game. The Celtics down by 14. They were down by as many as 20.
Well, they come back right now and get a field goal. Anything can happen here before this happens.
There is Antoine Walker. Ball away against Dennis Rodman. Walker now with 8 points. He is the leading scorer for the Celtics.
See, the one thing you know is that Boston's going to be pressing you for 48 minutes. You know that. Now, are you in good enough condition?
We'll find out.
Great.
Tell you what, the Bulls are glad they don't have to face this kind of team every game.
That's a double dribble. He dribbled, fake, and dribbled again.
Well, you're on the, you should be wearing that striped shirt.
That is my 2nd call. My 2nd good call.
2 balls in 1 half for you. And the foul is called against Tony Kukoc, who's picked up 3 in a hurry.
See, he dribbled right there. They gave him a dribble. Now watch, he fakes a net. He fakes around, and now watch what happens. See, this happens a lot in basketball. He dribbles again.
Well, you're right on it. Dennis Rodman leaves the game, replaced by Jason Caffey. Judd Bushler is going to check in a moment. And here's a great pass. Barrows misses the layup. Travis Knight led him perfectly. And now the Bulls come back. Kukoc left open for a 3. He's going to get another chance. Feeds Caffey, and a foul is called. Travis Knight felt he had all ball, but he'll be hit with the personal foul, his 2nd.
Now just keep an eye on this nice bounce pass. For once, Knight hits a cutter. Barros is going right in, but see, once again, the intimidation of the shot block. He lost his concentration. He missed the layup.
Did you say for once?
Yeah, you know why? Because Knight has passed the ball more times to Chicago than he has passed to the post guy.
Okay, wanted to clarify that.
No,
you're right about that.
We read that Knight is at your center. He's playing up high, 7 foot, 255. He's going to shoot threes and make jump shots and then feed the post. Well, unfortunately, tonight, things aren't working out that well.
And Travis Knight, who played with the Lakers last year, a free agent pickup. By the way, Knight was the number one pick by the Chicago Bulls last year, and they renounced the rights to Travis Knight. He wound up with the Lakers.
Well, it's a great deal for the young man because he was a free agent, went to the Lakers. Shaq gets injured, gets playing time, puts together some very nice numbers, and as a matter of fact, led the Lakers in rebounding on 9 occasions last year.
Played good defense. Very impressive rookie. Andrew DeClark replaces Knight. Posting up against Mercer is Jordan. They doubled in a hurry. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Joe Bushler from the corner. And the rebound, Barrows. Very active veteran is Dana Barrows in his ninth year. Antoine Walker lost the ball out of bounds. And good decoy defense by the Bulls as first they flashed Steve Kerr and then Jason Caffey. And Walker lost it out of bounds.
Just want to bring up that one little point again. Now, that was good defense. They forced the timeout. Jason Caffey calls a 22nd in the backcourt. In spite of this horrendous shooting by Boston, the rash of turnovers, you look at the clock, they are down only 12.
That is hard to believe. When you look at the poor shooting, 16 turnovers, you would think that this game, if such a game in the NBA, could be salted away in the second quarter, but that is not the case.
Well, that's what this style of play will do. This style of play plays in peaks and valleys. It's chaotic, but you have to be in physical condition to remember that this is going to be the pace for 48 minutes.
And let's take a look once again at the difference. What a contrast in ages, experience, all of that between these teams.
Well, we said that it's the youngest team in the NBA in the last 10 years. You see the games, you see the rings, you see the All-Star thing. But how about tonight, the starting team? One rookie, three guys with only 1 year in the league, and then Dana Barrows with 8 years. See, I thought we would see more trapping back there, but maybe they're feeling him out, and we'll see that in the second half, Dick.
Caffey feeding, Harper driving the lane, and a foul called against Andrew DeClark. Bulls ice cold in the second quarter, only 2 for 13 from the field. How much would you put that on the fact that the Celtics are making them work to bring the ball?
Oh, absolutely. No, Dick, there's no doubt about that. But also, we said at the top of the show, you take Scottie Pippen out of this mix, you're not only talking 20 points, you're talking 6 assists. He's the leading assist guy on this team. Then you are also taking out of the mix here is your defensive board play and then also the all defense, you know, for 6 straight years. So you know that he is a major, major loss.
Started every game last year, and with foot surgery, out of action now. Chauncey Billups has come in the game for the Celtics, the rookie point guard. Bulls retain the ball after the miss. 4:15 to go in the first half, 37-24. 13-point lead for the Bulls. Ron Harper with it, working against Billups. And they're going to call a foul on the rookie.
In the last 3 minutes, Dick, once we got down to about 7 minutes in this quarter, their half-court pressure has improved 100%. They are up guarding people right now. They're making it difficult for them to run the triangle, and they're not giving them high-percentage shots. But it only kicked in within the last 3 minutes.
Well, Rick Pitino knows this is not a one-year deal. It's going to take several years, but he's done it everywhere he's gone. Judd Bushler hitting from the corner. You name it, Pitino's done it, and he has gotten success everywhere he has coached. 39-24 with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the first half. Jordan with 10. Kukoc on the bench with 10 with 3 fouls. Leading the Bulls, and Antoine Walker with 8 tops the Celtics. 8 on the shot clock now. Billups tries to get it in low, knocked away by George. Nice. Good pass to Walker. Antoine Walker, the first Celtic to get into double figures. And it is a 13-point Chicago lead.
Billups is the only player on the Celtics who has been able to beat his man, get down inside, and make something happen. Now, there we just had a nice trap in the backcourt, force them to work their way out of it.
You mentioned Billups, who has struggled big time in preseason.
Yes, he has. And unfortunately for him, already they're talking about trades involving the young man. That's very difficult when you're the third pick.
Michael Jordan And Harper misses, and the rebound by Bowen. You got to like Bruce Bowen and what he has shown in this first half. And Walker couldn't control another Boston turnover with 2:40 to go. Well, this is a scrambling Boston Celtic team all over the floor. Jordan goes in, and they're going to call the blocking foul.
Oh, he gets the call.
He gets the call and gets the basket.
And Phil Jackson just gave us a quick movement better than at any time that he played for the Knicks. He was off the bench and he came
right back.
Now watch Michael make his move here. Now as he comes in here, the defender moved right in front. Now, no doubt about it, he was there. He was in front of the box. He was not in the box. Now just keep an eye on it. And I watch the defensive player. See, he's right there. But unfortunately for that young man, the guy who elevated was number 23.
Let's not forget that.
I'm the cool cat who read all that, every book from front to back. I even read the tiny type. I read each one from day to night. I read about that famous flight and was terrified by tales of fright. Every page, I did indeed. I'm one cool cat who loves to read. It's not coincidental. Reading is fundamental.
On TNT is brought to you by Jeep, makers of the Jeep Grand Cherokee, Cherokee, and Wrangler. By Burger King, where you can get your burgers worth. And by Champion, nothing matters but the game.
.234 remaining in the first half. The Bulls lead the Celtics 41-26, and that woman told us before the game, Hubie, she's been coming to see the Celtics for 50 years.
She and her husband sit right here at half court. I came in the league in 73. They were there then. And, you know, you're talking quite a few years. How about 50 years coming to see the Celtics? And you know what? It's so nice. They stay even keel.
Right.
You know what I mean? No matter during the great days, during the bad days.
Never got
here.
A technical foul.
Yeah, they're here every night.
You talk about loyalty.
Michael Jordan now with 13 points, 42-26 with 2:29 to go. That's right. The Celtics have scored only 26 points, although the bank shot by Chauncey Billups, he shows a little magic out there.
Oh, I like what Billups is doing here. He's the only guy that's capable of blowing by. And, you know, we always got to go back and underline the fact that the Bulls' half-court defense is one of the top half-court defenses in the league.
Kerr picked up by DeClercq on the switch. Bushler and Kerr, along with Ron Harper, Jason Caffey, and His Highness number 23, Michael Jordan, has got the ball. Under 2 minutes to go at the buzzer. Jordan misses a fall away, and the Celtics control. Here is Chauncey Billups.
Look up.
He's with Mercer, DeClercq, Bowen, and Antoine Walker posting up against Jason Caffey. Here is Walker working in, gets his own rebound and puts it in. Antoine Walker, who played all five positions as a rookie for the Celtics last year, brings him to within 12 once again.
Oh, that was a great move there, because not only did he shoot it, but he went right over the top of Caffey.
Caffey driving in, and the foul will be against the Celtics. Bruce Bowen winds up on the Fleet center floor.
Well, the people in the building want to travel here right now, but just keep an eye on Caffey. Caffey is really hustling. See, once he comes down in here, he lifts his pivot foot there. See, there's the travel. Okay? And
because he never got the shot off. If you're going to lift your pivot foot after you take the two-step, you've got to pass or shoot the basketball. He never got to that.
Jason Caffey misses the first free throw. Coming up on the Nike Halftime Report, Ernie Johnson, Cheryl Miller, and Reggie Theus will be in our Atlanta studios with all the scores and highlights from opening night. Plus, Greg Ostertag reacts to today's incident with Shaquille O'Neal. It was at the shoot-around. The Jazz and the Lakers getting set to tip it off in the second half of our opening night TNT doubleheader. 14th year, Turner Sports has covered NBA action. Caffey makes one out of two.
Caffey very quietly is doing a nice job, just like he did in the exhibitions. He was the only player, other than Michael Jordan, to average double figures during the eight exhibition games for Chicago.
9 points and four rebounds in the game for Caffey, and that was D. Brown with the jump shot. 43-32. It's an 11-point game as we wind down to a minute to go. The Celtics with all of their opening night young jitters. Bowen and Jordan misses from outside. And here comes Walker. Bowen got that last basket. He has four in the game. Antoine Walker nearly lost it off his foot. 10 on the shot clock. Mercer fires it up, and Bowen gets position and gets the ball. It'll be Celtics ball and a new clock.
Antoine Walker, Dick, makes an awful lot of things happen. Unfortunately, he's very careless with the basketball and turns the ball over very easily. Now, during the exhibitions, he's having close to four turnovers a game, and we see tonight he is really struggling. He's out far. So if you're playing him defensively, you play him for the drive, and you tell him, hey, you got to beat me with an outside jump shot, but I'm gonna play the drive. I'm not going to let you get into the painted area.
20-second timeout called by Phil Jackson and the Bulls.
I know this sounds crazy. I'm Rick Pitino. We just played the worst half that any of us could have imagined. We all thought that we'd play a higher quality of basketball. If I can keep this game at 11, I go in right now. Not a bad half. Okay, I am at home. And we all talk about building up confidence. They have six of their first eight games at home.
Dennis Rodman in the ballgame now for the Bulls.
There you go.
Walker with the turnaround. 14 points. 10 of them coming here in the second quarter for Antoine Walker, and it's a 9-point game. The Bulls in front. They have led all the way in this one. As we now have under 20 seconds to go, 13 on the shot clock for the Bulls.
Remember, you also trap in the backcourt, not because you're running precious seconds off the clock.
Now the final 9 seconds, four on the shot clock. Jordan misses the bank shot, and here is Dana Barros.
You have time. You have time.
And Barros is fouled by Ron Harper with 3.7 seconds left. That is the 14th foul against the Chicago Bulls.
Good foul.
Good and the first foul in the last 2 minutes, so that was a good foul, and the Celtics will have to inbound.
Good foul by Harper. Now, we're giving Harper a lot of credit that he knew that they had one to give, okay?
When in doubt, do that.
Yeah, excellent, excellent play.
Bowen gets it in. Harper stepped on the line, but now 2.7 showing on the clock.
Well, you have plenty of time to make a catch and get off at least one good dribble. All right, so you got to make something happen here now.
Here's Walker with Caffey in his face. Time running out, and Walker fires it up. Michael Jordan came at him to double team him, and that got Walker on of it. But the Boston Celtics are the closest they've been since 5 minutes left in the first quarter, as Jordan with 13 points. Walker has 14 to lead Boston. And after halftime here at the Fleet Center, the Bulls lead the Celtics 43-34.
It's an NBA preview, one-on-one, tomorrow.
The moral of the story? Get the world's fastest sport utility vehicle. Introducing the Grand Cherokee 5.9 Limited. Get low 4.8 APR financing or get great lease rates.
I know we can make it.
I know that we can.
I know darn well we can work it out. Yes, we can. I know we can. Yes, we can. Oh, why can't we? If we want it, yes, we can. Yes, we can. I know we can. Yes, we can. Oh, why can't we? If we want it, yes, we can.
I know we can make it work. I know we can make it if we try.
Oh, yes, we can. I know we can. Yes, we can.
We got your mind.
Oh, yes, we can. I know we can.
Nathanson Creek.
I think I know what that swoosh means. And I can read halftime report, too. It must be halftime. Must be the Nike halftime report. Bulls on top, 43-34. Michael Jordan has got 13. Not shooting the ball particularly well, 4 out of 11, but they do have the lead. In our Atlanta studio, Ernie Johnson joined by our opening night tandem, Cheryl Miller, Reggie Theus. It is the Nike halftime report. Before we hit the highlights, the headlines. Charles Barkley won't retire. That's what he said after meeting with NBA Deputy Commissioner Russ Granick. Now, that meeting stemmed from the incident in Orlando when Barkley threw the guy through the window. Bottom line on that is that Sir Charles will take bodyguards with him when he hits the town. Meantime, there were some fireworks at the Forum in Los Angeles this morning. Shaquille O'Neal and Utah's Greg Ostertag, who went at each other pretty good in the playoffs last season, had words at shoot-around this morning, and Shaq decked the Utah big guy with an open hand. The NBA is looking into it. Ostertag told our Brian Burwell he's not going to dwell on it.
I came here to play basketball, and I'm going to go out and I'm going to give it my best. I'm going to play my hardest tonight. You know, it's something I'm going to try to do every game. You know, I'm not going to change the way I play because of it. I don't know about how much respect I got anyway, so, you know, on the court. So, you know, I need to make a name for myself sometimes. But, yeah, it's in the past now.
Tag looking.